Welcome to the Bark for More podcast, the essential guide to raising a healthy and happy dog, from barkformore.com. Hosted by our top-notch team of dog enthusiasts, we're here to help you navigate the health and well-being of your canine friend. It's time to help your dog thrive.
Hello and welcome to today's episode, Ringworm in Dogs. When we think about ringworm, we immediately think that it came from worms, but in reality, fungus causes ringworm. Ringworm is a common name given to a fungal infection of the superficial layers of the skin, hair, and nails. Despite its name, ringworm is not a worm at all. The ring refers to the circular lesions that appear with the infection found in the outer layers of the skin, hair, and nails. In our dogs, it mostly appears in areas as hair loss. Ringworm infections can infect humans and all domesticated animals and allow the transmission of the fungus from dogs to humans. As pet parents, we are scared for our dogs because there are tons of places to get them. In this episode, I'm going to discuss the signs and symptoms of ringworm, what causes them, and how we can treat them. Ringworm can be contagious when transmitted. Transmission occurs by direct contact of the fungus. The transmission also occurs by direct contact with an infected animal, person, or our dog's bedding, toys, brushes, clippers, and other objects that can harbor the infection. The symptoms of ringworm appear on our dog's skin, hair, ears, limbs, nails, and can also occur in different locations on their body. When flaking of the skin, hair loss, and dry and brittle hair is present, it is a sign that our dogs are infected. Other symptoms include rings of inflamed skin and brittle claws that appear to be red or darkened in color. Luckily, ringworm is not that life-threatening, but prevention is better than cure. If we see symptoms of ringworm appearing in our dogs, we need to call our vet and begin treatment right away. It is also best to know where our dogs might get it. As much as our dogs like to dig, we need to know that the fungus resides in soil. So, we need to be careful in letting our dogs go outside. Even our home furnishings and rugs can harbor infection. Fungal spores can reside and lay dormant on a variety of surfaces, like combs, brushes, and food bowls. The fungus can stay dormant for 18 months, which makes it difficult to avoid. However, direct contact with the fungus is not the only possibility. Dogs that have low immune systems are more at risk. Dogs that are more prone to the infection are puppies, older dogs, dogs living in shelters, and dogs living with infected humans. Regardless of the severity of the case, treatment of ringworm in dogs is always necessary to avoid the spread of infection to children or other pets. It also involves cleaning the fungus from our living environment. Our veterinarian will come up with a plan to treat the infection as well as a plan to sterilize and disinfect our home the proper way. The amount of environmental contamination is a huge factor in preventing the buildup of the fungus. That is why we need to practice proper cleaning and disinfecting, especially in our homes. Topical ointments are prescribed by our vet to help clear out the infection, along with medical shampoo and lotions. Topical ointments are used alone for the treatment of ringworm, and it is used in combination with oral medications. Some antifungal medications can be given orally as well. I recommend listening to our local vet when to stop our dog's medication. Stopping medication too early can result in the recurrence of the fungus. Besides, we should not only be treating our dogs. Treating our environment should also be considered. If our dogs are infected, it is best to keep them quarantined to prevent them from spreading the fungus around. The use of gloves is a must when disposing of rugs and carpets that our pets have been in contact with. washing of the beddings and toys with a bleach solution is good too. Or better yet, dispose of them and replace them with something new. Now that you know, keep a lookout for these signs. Let's do what we can to prevent our favorite furry pals from contracting ringworm in the first place. As always, it's up to us pet parents to do our part to keep our pets happy, healthy, and safe.
Thank you for listening to the Bark for More podcast. Don't forget to subscribe to catch every episode. Visit us at barkformore.com to sign up for the latest updates and follow us on social media. Until next time, keep those happy tails wagging.